Well, we're switching gears here. It's only the middle of May, just a couple days after turkey season. But decided to get out between the rains and start doing some deer scouting. Seen some bucks sprouting and whatnot already. I believe it was turkey hunting there. Anyway, I'm gonna try to do a little different format with this video. Quite frankly, our turkey season wasn't that great, but mainly issues with time. I didn't have a lot of time to get out, then wasn't able to go and film and do all that stuff. And when we did, there was a lot of rain, but we still got out, we still had fun, and got a couple videos. Hopefully you guys will enjoy watching them. All right, this first video that gonna put up here is actually one of the only times I had personally gotten to go. It was just after the youth season. I had taken my kids out during the youth season, and we didn't do any good. We didn't really see or hear anything. A couple of hens and whatnot, but anyway, I had already scheduled a few days off work to go hunt with another buddy of mine, and I had decided that I was going to take my bow. Alright, so after I had had my encounter with that bird, you know, with my bow and the blind, and he totally just went right around us and just did not want to have anything to do with what we had in front of the blind, and I could not make a shot happen. I hunted two more days with my bow and did not see another bird. Then naturally I had to go back to work and decided to wait till the next weekend, and I was able to take my son out and get him on a bird too. And
Let me tell you, if you ever get the opportunity to take a 6-year roll out in the turkey woods, exciting things always happen, and the emotions run high, even for the adult, you know, taking the hunt. So definitely, if you get a chance, take a kid hunting. I guarantee both will never forget the experience.
That's why that Tom won't come to us. I've got these stinking hands.
Good video of him anyway.
Yes,
he was big old long beard.
Maybe we should go around the horizon.
No, he's seen us. We should leave him alone now.
Well, we should sneak actually in the horizon, peek through the other side and shoot him.
The crazy thing is there was a hen right behind us.
Yeah.
instead of picking the gun up. Okay? See how that sticks in the way?
Yeah.
Let me see your gun. I'll show you. See? Instead of, you know, when you couldn't swing over here to shoot it over there, instead of picking it up like this, that's what the turkey saw.
You could just do that.
Yeah, pull it back like this, and then through.
That's what we saw.
Yeah, see how that, it's less movement. He's done, he knows he was lucky today.
Oh yeah, if he was over on this side, I already shot him.
I know.
He came from...
Just think, if we would have been facing that way, like where we first sat down, but we had to move up on him because he wouldn't move. That took a long, long time to get that turkey to move.
If we were behind that tree, it would be a different story.
Oh, absolutely.
And if I was on this side, it would be a way different story.
Yeah.
I'd be able to shoot him right off the bat.
Well, if you had got ready when I told you, I seen him coming right through there. And he couldn't see us. And he was all strutting around, you know. That's what's fun about hunting these turkeys in the thick woods instead of, you know, out in the open.
He knew what was going on.
Now, after that experience with my son, which is such a heartbreak. I mean, he had the bird right there, maybe 7 yards. Took us 2 hours to work that bird in, and he had hens. He was just so ecstatic, and that's the point I want to make. Even though we didn't make a harvest on that, both of us had such an experience. It was such a great time as a father and son thing that I encourage anyone to take a kid, no matter if it's their own kid or somebody else's, it doesn't matter. It's just the total experience. That's what hunting is. So don't think you have to kill something to make it a total experience. Anyway, after all of that, I decide that, hey, we need to get my wife out and get her going, because normally she doesn't have a lot of time either. So I start projecting on trying to get her a turkey, and I mean, she's got to be one of the luckiest people I've ever met. The last couple times, I mean, yeah, she goes maybe two, three days, I don't know, out of the year, and usually always ends up in a perfect situation. But in this particular case, we were actually traveling to a woods to hunt, and lo and behold, we passed turkeys in a field, and we just so happened to have permission to hunt that field and the woods behind it. And it was a recipe for success right from the start. You know, we were able to pull right up in there and get right on those birds. And whichever one you want, go ahead. till they separate. So. Will, you want a double?
Will, that one's still moving over there. The one you shot at, it's running down the hill.
Is he?
Yeah.
I couldn't figure out which one you were shooting.
I think I got him in flop. First one of the year.
I know, just a little Jake, but he'll do. He'll eat well.
I could see you over there sizing up their beards.
I was. I tricked the one with the beard sticking out the most. Oh, he got him.
Yeah, you gotta watch, they'll run and hide. Yeah, they're tough birds.
They didn't go very far, huh?
No, he didn't go very far at all.
Good double.
It was hard to get after he turned on me. And I was sitting down in that little dip. That's when he turned around on me. I'm like,
shit. I just picked the one with the beard to take it out the first.
Yeah, that's what I did too. See? These are the two biggest ones that I see.
Yeah.
Hell yeah. That's pretty good though. Getting ready to go hunting.
Look at him, he's been breathing heavy.
You see him out in the field, do this whole sneak attack on him, put the thunder chicken in the woods.
Awesome. In the midst of me trying to find time for myself to hunt, and my son, my wife, I also have a older daughter that likes to go. It was her turn. I was able to take her out a few times. We had some good experiences, but there again, unfortunately, things just weren't in her favor. But you watch the little bit of footage that I have on her, and you can see she's so excited. And if she was a little bit older, I was able to shoot a bigger gun, things would have happened for her. But... just get your gun in the semi ready.
safety on, but don't touch that tree. Just let him keep working around, he'll come in. Yeah, don't move. He's just checking everything out.
I feel like he's gonna come
in. He might. But he might come back too. He might go around and come in from the other side.
This is where I'll put in some of the extra stuff, like some of the deer that we seen, or you know, little tidbits of things that had happened, or some hen turkeys and whatnot, things that weren't a part of the actual hunt type videos. So stick around and check out some of these close encounters and things that had happened while we was out enjoying nature together. So.
Not a like dark turkey decoy. sounds totally different. She's over here just preening herself, picking through.
But I can't believe we just like literally stepped over that turkey. It's amazing. Is there?
I know, but what if I just ran off?
Yeah. I think when I moved into the trail to get a better video, I think he actually saw me. He didn't even know you was there. Yeah. Well, he's got a broken leg. He's probably not gonna run too far.
He's probably gonna die soon.
He might have got hit by a car or something. Let's go try to find some turkeys now, okay? Right there, look at that. Go stand beside it. That's almost as tall as you.
It's a beaver.
Yeah, beaver. Killed another tree.